Hello and welcome to Victory Update for Wednesday, July 22nd. Okay, let me have your attention. You listening? Listen up. You are going to make it. You are going to make it.
That's right.
There are no circumstances that you're dealing with that are bigger than your God. Just remember that. You're going to make it. And for this next half hour, you stay with us because we're going to talk about that today, about how you can rise above your circumstances and you have the authority and the ability to walk in victory. Okay? We don't call this Victory Channel for nothing because victory is something that belongs to you. Okay, I'm done for a moment. Now, listen, thanks for being with us today. We are going to have a good program today. And I have with me today as my co-host, Qwest Gatlin, and this is a good day.
It is a great day, and I'm so glad you said it. We don't call it the Victory Channel for no reason. Full of faith, full of victory in everything we do, everything our eyes look at. Amen and amen.
Yes.
Amen. Way to start it off.
Amen. Amen. And if you need prayer, listen, we have got something for you. We have a prayer center where we have trained prayer ministers all day long. And over there right now is Pastor Stephen Shelton, and he's going to talk to you about how you can get prayer and how important that is here at KCM. Stephen?
Hey guys, yeah, you know, as I walked into the Partner Service Center here earlier, I walked in and heard just this rumble of people praying. And it was our prayer ministers meeting together. And I tell you, the anointing was tangible. The presence of God is strong in this place at all times because prayer is constantly going out. And you can call and be a part of that, 877-281-6297. It is our great honor and privilege to come into agreement with our partners, with our friends, and come with you to the throne of God and present your needs and the things that are on your heart to Him. We believe that where two or more are gathered in His name, there He is in the midst of that. And with technology being amazing, you can call in and we can talk and be in agreement over the phone. 877-281-6297. We want to hear from you. We want to pray with you and we want to hear your testimony because we know God is doing awesome things in your life. So we want to hear about that. 877-281-6297. Call now. We want to hear from you.
Oh, that's great, Stephen. Thank you. Now, listen, here at Kenneth Copeland Ministries, we have all kinds of resources available to you to help you know who you are and what you can do as a believer. And I'm going to let Qwest tell you about what we've got for you today.
Yeah, listen, this is available. It's an 8-CD series. It's available to you via MP3, of course. So that means it's a digital download, but it's available to you for free. It's Understanding Who You Are in Christ. It's an MP3. Of course, it's physically, it's an 8-CD series, but available to you for digital download. It's by Kenneth Copeland. You can get it at govictory.com/victory update.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen. Now, every time about this day, about this time every day, we break away from the news. And So let's bring in Mike Garofalo for our news break. And Mike, I understand we've got some news concerning U.S.-China relations.
We do, Tim, and it's a bit unsettling. The U.S. says it has ordered China to close its consulate in Houston within 72 hours to protect American intellectual property and the private information of Americans. And this morning, China said it will retaliate if the U.S. does not revoke that decision. We've also heard from Florida Senator Marco Rubio, Republican. He tweeted, China's Houston consulate is a massive spy center. Forcing it to close is long overdue. Rubio described the Houston consulate as a central node of the Chinese Communist Party's spy operations. Also in Houston, firefighters responded to reports of papers being burned at the consulate grounds Tuesday night, but they were barred entry. A shooting on Chicago's South Side left 15 people injured. It happened on Tuesday evening as mourners stood outside of a funeral home. Police say several targets of that shooting returned fire. The victims were taken to area hospitals, most in serious to critical condition. And while those bullets were flying, the mayor of Chicago was taking her own pot shots at President Trump. Lori Lightfoot was holding a press conference saying the president is trying to terrorize the city by sending in federal agents to try to stop the skyrocketing crime. Just last Friday, Chicago police and rioters clashed near the city's Christopher Columbus statue. Nearly 20 police officers were injured as rioters hurled objects at them. We recently told you about California Governor Gavin Newsom's ban on indoor worship services and the lawsuit filed by Harvest Rock Church in an attempt to block that order. Now we've learned the governor's order also applies to home Bible studies, fellowship groups, and praise and worship singing. As part of its argument, Harvest Rock states that it cannot fulfill its vital ministry without gathering together in person. 10 states have been added to the New York area's tri-state quarantine list. Governor Andrew Cuomo made the announcement on Tuesday as much of the country continues to see a spike in coronavirus cases. Now, among those states, including Virginia, Maryland, and Delaware, total now stands at 31, where visitors to the New York area must self-quarantine for 14 days. Minnesota was just taken off of that list. Colorado is rolling back some of its coronavirus restrictions it had lifted. On Tuesday, Governor Jared Polis ordered all bars and restaurants to stop serving alcohol past 10 p.m. The governor said he is doing so as coronavirus cases among young adults begin to rise in the state. The order is expected to take effect before the weekend. Currently, last call in Colorado is at 2 a.m. It could be a big payday for Pfizer and BioNTech if one of their COVID-19 vaccines is proven to be both safe and effective. The U.S. government says if everything works out, it will pay the two companies $1.95 billion to produce and deliver 100 million doses with an option for an additional 500 million. According to CNBC, BioNTech and Pfizer are together working on four potential vaccines. The price tag for the next COVID-19 aid package could quickly swell to more than $1 trillion. Currently, White House officials are meeting with Congress over money to reopen schools, prop up small businesses, boost virus testing, and keep cash flowing to Americans while the virus crisis deepens in the U.S. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell on Tuesday promised a new round of direct payments to earners below a certain income level, similar to the $1,200 payments in the spring. Now, meantime, the president is insisting on a payroll tax holiday for workers. As for the Democrats, they want billions to outfit schools and shore up local governments. Finding camps for kids to go to during the coronavirus pandemic is not easy. But when it comes to Christian camps in the U.S., CBN News is reporting that the Christian Camp and Conference Association members say more than half will hold their camps as planned. Those moving forward will be using CDC guidelines along with what local health authorities are requesting in order to create a safe environment. According to CBN, some camps are asking campers and their families to quarantine for 14 days before bringing their child to camp and even to take daily temperature checks in the 7 days leading up to the start of camp. Chalk up another victory to the cancel culture, as FaithWire reports after the City Council of Ventura, California, supposedly received thousands of email complaints about its two statues of Father Junipero Serra. The council voted unanimously to remove and relocate them. The Roman Catholic saint is credited with bringing Christianity to the west coast of North America and founding 9 of the 21 California missions. Los Angeles Archbishop Jose Gomez had a lot of supportive things to say about the father, including he lived and worked alongside Native peoples and spent his whole career defending their humanity and protesting crimes and indignities against them. The 6-0 decision to move the Serra statues in Ventura came just 1 week after a massive fire totally destroyed the 18th century mission church founded by Serra in San Gabriel. Back to you in the Victory Studio.
You know, Qwest, I am so thankful that in this world we live in today with the cancel culture, that they cannot cancel Jesus.
You cannot cancel Jesus, nor can you cancel His Spirit that is given to us as a comforter and as a guidance.
That's exactly right.
as a guiding light for us, especially during this time. You can't cancel that.
Yeah, yeah. So as long as you've got Him on your side,
that's right.
You can't be canceled. And listen, before we get to the praise break, let me remind you that tonight, join us on Home Group tonight at 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 Central. They're going to talk about the Holy Spirit tonight. So you want to make sure you're here for that program. Now, let's get to our praise break with Jonathan Sandu, Jacob Smith, and Bethany Griner. They're going to sing a song called Love Changes Everything. Enjoy.
I see His body breaking. I see His fingers bleed. I see the darkness tremble at the ground below His feet. And in the darkest hour, there on Calvary, He was completely broken, broken just for me. Broken for you and me.
That is absolutely the truth. His love changes everything. And I will tell you, as we told you at the beginning of the program today, you are going to be glad you came today, because we want you to know that your circumstances are not bigger than your God. You know, Spencer Nordyke is our guest today. He and his wife, Cindy, they've been in ministry for over 40 years. And it doesn't seem like it. They probably started when they were three. They've been traveling worldwide, preaching and teaching. And he's currently an instructor at Kenneth Copeland Bible College. And he's also an accomplished author. He loves to help people unlock God's destiny in their lives. He teaches and preaches with a prophetic anointing that is needed in the church today. This man has been my friend for over 30 years, and I can tell you he knows what he's talking about, because he helped me walk through a very difficult time in my life with some of the same principles that we're going to share today. Spencer, it's good to see you, my
friend.
It's
good to be here. It's good to see all you guys.
Let's talk about our circumstances and how we rise above the circumstances in our lives.
Well, starting with Jesus, okay? He lived above his circumstances. He lived in a different dimension and showed us how to do it. And when you think about that word circumstances, okay, circum like circumference, it's like what's surrounding you.
Right.
And stances, what has taken a stand against you. You know, when you take a stand, you have a stance on a certain topic or a subject. Mm. So it's those things that have surrounded you and taken a stand against you. All right, think about for just a second where we're at right now with the coronavirus.
Right.
Okay. What has it affected? It's affected families. It's affected incomes. It's affected health. It's affected everything. And so we're surrounded by circumstances. And everybody's circumstances have changed and are challenging. And, you know, more and more challenges come as people, you know, the unrest has built up. We just saw in the news. All of those things are happening. But there's a story here in Mark chapter 4 that really gives us some keys to how to rise up above circumstances and how to live in that place. So let's just go through that. Okay. We'll just set this up. It says in Mark chapter 4, verse 35, on the same day when evening had come, Jesus said to them, "Let us cross over to the other side." When they had left the multitude, they took along in the boat as he was, and other little boats were also with him. And a great windstorm rose, and the waves beat into the boat so that it was already filling. But he was in the storm, asleep on a pillow. And they woke him up and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" Then he arose and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, "Peace, be still." And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. But he said to them, "Why are you so fearful? How is it that you have no faith?" So here's what we're looking at here. This is just like our situation. They were surrounded by wind and waves.
Right.
They were surrounded by circumstances. And then, but Jesus was showing them how to rise above it, how to live above it. Mm. Now, he had just gotten done teaching the parable of the sower and the seed. And he wrapped that up in verse 24 by saying, the same amount of thought and study you give to the word you hear is the same amount of results you're going to get.
Right.
Wow.
Okay. And then he gave them a word in verse 35.
Right.
He said, and now they didn't know this was a word from heaven, but this was equivalent to "let there be light."
Yes.
This is like a word from God.
Yes.
He said, "Let us go to the other side." Now, if they had taken that word to heart, meditated on it, got it inside of them, they would have risen up above the storm.
Yeah.
They had a word from God. Mm. It gave them direction. It gave them strength.
Right.
It gave them the outcome.
Right.
What are we doing? We're going to the other side. He didn't say, "Let's go to the middle and drown." He didn't say, "Let's go to the bottom of the lake."
Right.
I mean, there's lots of things he didn't say, but he did say, "Let us go to the other side."
And that was his will.
That was his will.
He spoke his will in that situation.
Right.
And I think people don't understand. They think, well, if I had Jesus beside me, these guys were with Jesus.
It would be easy if I
had Jesus. If I had Jesus.
Right.
These guys were with him, and they still like, what are you talking about?
But here's a whole book full of the voice of Jesus in
right.
our lives. If we read the word and meditate on the word and study the word, something out of here is going to come alive in us. And then what we do with that, that sparks in us, is going to put you over the circumstances and situations. And so, you know, this is the structure, though. Here's three questions, okay? I want to pose this to the audience. Number one, what word has God given you about your situation? You either have a word or God's shown you something about this pandemic. God's shown you something about the next couple of months. God has placed something in your heart. And if you don't have that sense of what's ahead, then get into the Word and get a word from God. Get a sense of what's ahead. So that's the first question. What has God said to you about where we're going? Wow. The second question is, what are you doing to activate that word? The disciples got a word from God, but didn't do anything with it. They had God's word, but when the storm came, they were freaking out. I mean, they said two things. Master, don't you care? Which is really dumb to tell Jesus, you know, don't you care? Because of course he cares.
I can't judge. I said some pretty dumb things in my life too. So.
Me too. Yeah. And then it was like, don't you care that we're all gonna die? Which that was old thinking. That was fisherman thinking.
Yeah.
Because fisherman thinking is like, okay, big storm, we all die. So they had reverted back to something that, you know, they already knew they
in
were
the
familiar
flesh.
With in the flesh. Instead of taking the word of God,
we're
going to the other side.
Yeah.
Right.
Jesus was asleep on a pillow, but they could have risen up in that boat and gone, we're going to the other side. We're going to the other side. Peter, we're going to the other side. John, we're going to the other side. They could have done that.
That's right.
But they didn't do that.
That's right.
And then the third question is, what stance are you taking as a result of activating that word in your life? What stance are, you know, is the stand that, hey, here's what we're going to do.
Right.
You know, they could have said, hey, we are going no matter what.
Right.
If we drowned, we're coming back to life and going to the other side. If the boat blows up, we're going to the other side.
No quit.
If, going to the, other if side. The lake drains out and the ground opens up, we're going to the other side. It didn't matter what the circumstances were.
Right.
They were going to the other side.
Right.
Now, Jesus is so gracious, you know. They made it anyway.
Right.
Even though they didn't do what they were supposed to do, they made it anyway. But Jesus' comment to them was, why are you so fearful? They weren't full of faith because they hadn't meditated on that word. Why are you so fearful? How is it that you have no faith?
That's right.
Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word. What word? The word God gives you for your circumstance.
That's right.
What situation are you in, and what word has God given you or is God giving you for that situation? That's the thing that you take to heart, meditate on, let it become a part of you, causes you to rise up over the circumstances.
That's good.
So that you're not surrounded by
That's good.
Things standing against
That's
you.
Good.
You're
yeah.
up above them.
You know, the interesting thing, and you mentioned this a moment ago, that, you know, his will didn't change when they got in the middle of that lake.
No.
Because of the circumstance. His will did not change. So in your circumstance, his will for your life has not changed. It's and the grace is still there.
Yes.
And the anointing is still there. And the calling is still there.
Mm. Right. And he'll help you. Even if you mess it up, he'll help you. You know, they messed it up. But he still helped them. They still made it to the other side. They still got what Jesus said.
Wow.
But I would rather do this well, you know?
Right.
I would rather do this well than fumble through Christianity and fumble through, you know, we're supposed to live a victorious life.
Yeah.
Not fumble around and try and figure it out,
right.
you know?
Yeah.
So getting a word from God on the situation and the direction that we're going and just meditating on that and taking a stand and saying, this is what it is. I mean, no matter what circumstances happen or come or change or whatever, this is what God said and this is what we're going
to
do.
Yeah, so you talked about how to get the word that God gave you. But how do we activate it? How do you activate the word God gave you?
Okay, it's in 2010, I'll just tell you a story. In 2010, on a Mother's Day, we were getting ready to go to church. Cindy was putting on her makeup, and the Lord spoke to her. The Holy Spirit spoke to her heart and said, you're getting ready to go through a tough situation, but I'm going to be with you every step of the way, and it's going to turn out okay. Well, starting that day, she couldn't hold down any food. And you know, for several days, she couldn't eat. And then all of a sudden, we had to go to the hospital, and she had to have emergency hernia surgery. And so all of a sudden we had these big hospital bills. Well, they discovered with all of this that she had some fibroid tumors. So they scheduled her several months later to go in and to have another operation to remove those. And so it was about 6 months later. Well, then that was more hospital bills, and that was more challenges physically. We were going through some transitions with, you know, ministry. And so, I mean, on every front, we were surrounded by circumstances, mm-hmm. emotionally, relationally, yeah. financially, mm-hmm. physically. We were surrounded by circumstances. Well, Cindy had this word from God. The Holy Spirit had spoken to her. She was standing on that. No matter what's going on, she's like, we're going to the other side. You know, well, I got into this word and I said, okay, God, I need something that covers more than just, you know, a physical healing. I need something that covers all of these different areas because I'm surrounded. So I went to 2 Corinthians 9:8. God is able to make all grace, every favor and earthly blessing come to you in abundance so that you may always and under all circumstances and whatever the need, be self-sufficient, possessing enough to require no aid or support and furnish an abundance for every good work. I took that scripture and I took it in several different translations. That was Amplified. And I said it 100 times. And then I got another translation and said it 100 times. What am I doing? I'm working it into the soil of my heart.
So good.
And the soil of my life. I'm saying it over and over and over and over until it became, I counted 100 times.
Yeah.
And then I'd go to another translation and then I'd do it again. And then I'd do it again until it was a part of me, until I was walking in all grace. And God worked it out. We had a whole lot of hospital bills canceled.
Praise God.
I mean, we had miracle after miracle after miracle after miracle. God brought us through it. We got on the other side of it. But we were surrounded by circumstances.
That works for you because you're a preacher, though.
Well, at that time, I wasn't on staff anywhere. Right. At that time, I didn't have a church anywhere. At that time, I wasn't traveling and ministering because I was staying home taking care of Cindy. And so we weren't. at that moment in life. Yeah. And so, but we took the word, we got the word from God and we took that word and we made it a part. We worked the word, just like if you're a farmer, you get a piece of land, you work the land, you get the rocks out, you get the weeds out, you dig that up. That's what I was doing with the word of God in my heart and in my life so that my life could bear fruit. Bear what kind of fruit? Wow. Health and healing.
Yes.
Prosperity.
Yeah. So good.
Peace in my heart when I'm surrounded by all kinds of junk, you know? And that's how you work the word. You work it like a farmer works his land.
Yes.
That's
right. Yes.
And I think a lot of people don't really understand that or don't really grasp that. You can take the word of God and just fold it into your life in such a way that it's going to cause you to be victorious no matter what circumstances you're facing.
Take a minute and pray for the people.
Okay. Father, in the name of Jesus, we just release faith in your word. Father, we release, Lord God, a clarity, a hearing of the Spirit of God in these circumstances and situations. Right now, God's beginning to speak to some of you. God's showing some of you something. God's giving you a scripture verse in your heart, or God's showing you something that He already told you, and He's causing that to rise up. Take a hold of that and build that into your life. Meditate on it, say it over and over again, say it to your circumstances and let them change. Father, in the name of Jesus, a new grace to rise up above these circumstances. We release miracles in finances, miracles in health, miracles, Father, with family and children and marriages and relationships. Father, everyone who's surrounded by circumstances, in Jesus' name, those circumstances are changing. We speak to them to change.
Praise God.
Peace be still in Jesus' name.
Amen. Boy, isn't that powerful? Now listen, I know that that blessed you today. Here's how you can connect with Spencer. There's his book right there on the screen. It's called Living the Fillionaire Life. You want to get a copy of that. NordykeMinistries.com. You can get that book. You can get other resources that they have. Make yourself available to those things because these folks have dedicated their lives to ministering to people and you will be blessed. Listen, folks, do not miss the show tonight. What do we call that program?
Home group tonight.
Thank you.
Holy Spirit.
Your home group. Don't miss your home group tonight at 8, 7 Central about Holy Spirit. So don't miss that. Don't miss morning prayer tomorrow morning at 9:30 a.m. Eastern. And then this program tomorrow at 5 p.m. Eastern. Thank you guys for being with us today. We're going to go out with music and we appreciate you. We'll see you back here tomorrow.